my video for Altenew guest designer spot. I will be creating a mixed media layout using a various stamp set and embellishments, and I'm starting with this always there flower stamp set, and I'm using only the outline stamps, and I'm stamping them using embossing ink and very pretty rose gold embossing powder. It looks quite dark when I apply it, but when you heat it up, it has a pretty, very pretty color. And I would say it's a perfect rose gold. I was searching for this kind of color for some time, and I'm happy I ordered some from Altenew because the quality is great and the color is really rose gold. It's not a yellow gold or, you know, a very copper color. It's a perfect rose gold. I am stamping several flowers, not only those six you are seeing right now. I am stamping much more, but I cut it off because it's not important for you to see me stamping it like 20 times. And after that, you can either use a coordinating die. I think there is a coordinating die for this stamp set, or use scissors like me. I sometimes feel it's faster to fussy cut elements than cut them with dies, especially when the shape is not complicated. So it's fine, I don't have this coordinating die, but for sure it sometimes fasten up the process. After it's all fussy cutted, I am coloring the elements using they are kind of watercolor paints with a shimmer pigment. They are from Shimmers, but you can use any other watercolors that are hard, liquid watercolors. You can also use mists and use them like liquid watercolors, whatever you have on hand. I used a watercolor paper to stamp my images, so I'm not worried about adding too much water to them. And I recommend you to use a watercolor paper too, or some thicker cardstock that can handle some water. And after I'm done with this layout, I think, why I didn't start with painting the flowers and then fussy cut them? I think it would be a wiser decision, but well... This is the thought I have right now when I'm recording a voiceover, and maybe next time I will start with coloring the elements and then fussy cut them. I wouldn't have to, you know, hold them with my nail so they won't fly out from the painting spot. I am using a few shades of pink color because I am planning to create a mostly rose gold and pink layout with a little hint of green color. So I'm just, you know, mixing the colors. I also added some watercolors because the shade of pink I had in this little jar was just too pale and it wasn't visible after it was dry. And all my flowers are dry, so I can start creating a background. Once again, I am using a watercolor paper sheet as a base of my layout. That's why I can add a lot of water. If you are not having this paper, do not add that much water. Try some different technique for the background, because this one really requires having watercolor paper, or at least a very thick paper that can you know, give you a little amount of time to spread the color, so it can't adhere the color immediately. I am using the same shade of pink I used to paint the flowers, and I am measuring with my picture if there is enough pink space, so it won't look like that after I will glue down the picture, the background won't be visible, so it will be just like, you know, a wasted time. And now I am using this stamp set. It's called Watercolor Dots, and I really, really love it. I use it on a few projects recently because it's my newest purchase. And I love how versatile it is, not only for card makers, but for scrapbookers too. I chose one of the pink colors. I don't remember the name. They are from the cherry blossom set. It's a second color, like second from the lightest. And I am stamping it on the background, pressing with my fingers. I am not using acrylic block because I only want the dots on the areas where I applied the pink color on the background. So it will harden the effect. I am not using the correct word, I think. So I'm pressing it only on some places, not all over the stamp. It's a very fun technique for mixed media background, and you can use many stamps to use it to create it, especially the background stamps. You can have different colors one on another, or like me, the same shades, the different shades of the same color. And this stamp set has also those tiny kind of a circles that you can add over the lighter background, and I am using them to stamp some extra elements. First, I started with dots, but it wasn't too visible, so I switch into the like a hand-drawn circle. You will see it right away, and I stamped over a few of my dots, and it's much more visible. And I also took a heart and an embossing ink, and I stamped the heart on some of the circles, and then I added my rose gold embossing ink, adding this rose gold color on the background too, so it connects with the flowers. And now I will heat it up to melt the powder. I have very old heat tool, but it's still working, but it's not the best one. It really, really make a lot of noise, so it's hard to speak when it's on. And after my background is done, I am building a composition behind my picture. I decided to use only a, I don't know, what is it in English? It's not a vellum. You can see what it is, especially when it came with some, a packaging inside. I knew the word, sorry, I forgot it. So this is some kind of a recycling from my scrapbooking orders, and they were wrapped in this paper, and I decided it would be fun to use it as a background. I'm not adding any pattern papers because I want to keep it airy. I want my flowers to be main focus of the page. Of course, first goes the picture and later goes the flower, but sometimes like embellishments like to overshadow, is it a good word, the picture. But it's also fine because I do not always want to only scrap a memory. Sometimes I just want to make something pretty, and this is the case of making something pretty because I already used this picture on other layout, and I just like her face here, so I decided to scrap it again. I am arranging my flowers, and after I will be happy how they look, I will glue them down using 3D foam squares, creating kind of a dimensional composition. And now I am playing with layered floral elements die, and I will be cutting out a few small flowers and branches using gold paper. Yeah, it was me, and it's still me, like in a mirror. And I am using this very cute and very handy little die cutting machine from Altenew to cut out the elements I needed. And I will do the same several times until I will have more branches and more flowers. And after they are all cutted out, I am adding them to my composition. Behind the flowers, I added a pieces of foam, so they are also a little bit dimensional, not a thick foam, but still it has a little bit shadow around it, and it looks much nicer on pictures when you photograph your projects. Then everything is glued down, like with no 3D foam squares. Now it's time to add some final touches, and I am using those adhesive wood veneers. They are called sweethearts, and I am covering them with my embossing ink. Yeah, you can do it. You can just dip the wood veneer in embossing powder and heat it up, and it will cover the wood perfectly. So you can alter many of your wooden elements into other ones in matching colors, especially if you have a lot of embossing powders. If you want to get this more like a glaze looking surface, you just have to repeat the process a few times. So add the ink, add the powder, heat it up. Once again, add the ink, once again, add the powder, heat it up, and it will create a very thick layer that will look like a glaze on the cake, I would say. I have to hold my hearts because they are flying away because of the blow of the heat gun. But as you can see, that they are changing the color from this very dark to pretty shiny rose gold color. But you can still see this wood texture, which really, really makes me happy because I like this effect. If you don't like it, just apply more layers of embossing powder. And my title will be happy. So I have already a happy part, and I will need a B word too. And for that, I will use fine alphabet die set. I didn't cut it out into a single letter, so it won't fit into my handy Altenew die cutting machine. I had to use some bigger one. You can split them apart, but I'm always like losing letters, and I don't like doing it. I prefer to keep it all in one, and thanks to that, I know I won't lose a single letter. And my finishing touches are adding enamel dots. They are from a Red Cosmos set, and this is something quite new. I think it's like from 2 months old, and it came up with the release along with adhesive wood veneers that I already used. And the real final touch is splashing everything with gold mist, and voila, my project is ready. That's it. This is the whole process. It's a lot of mixed media, but it's also a lot of fun. Thank you for stopping by, watching this video. Check the description box below for all the links to the post, to the products. And this is it. See you on the Altenew blog, and you can also visit my own blog and YouTube channel for more videos. Bye bye.